This is Ezekiel 1 and 4. And I looked, and behold, a whirlwind come out of the north, a great cloud, and a fire enfolding itself, and a brightness was about it, and out of the midst thereof as a color of flame, out of the midst of the fire. Praise be to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakatash, the Bohanas, to the apostle and the elder of Christmaston. This blessing and salutation to the Akiam, pushing this truth to the four winds of the heaven. It is Brother Yosia who coming to you with this precept again. So, I promised to do a lesson about it. I only did about maneuver. A chariot is maneuvering in the... Oh, I did about how the chariot maneuvers, how the chariot travel in military formation, and I promised to do a lesson about how a chariot move like a whirlwind, man. Like how a tornado move. A tornado move forward, and at the same time it is rotating clockwise, clockwise or anti-clockwise motion, man. That is a rotator motion, man. And the chariot move like that, man. Today we are going to prove, so the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, Lord willing, man. So this was Ezekiel 1 and 4, and I looked, and behold, a whirlwind come out of the north, a great cloud, and a fire enfolding itself. Remember, it is a whirlwind, and at the same time, a fire enfolding itself. So it is just rotating like a tornado, man. That's a whirlwind from the north, man. A wheels in wheels, man. And a wheels in wheels. A wheel is rotating, and the wheels in wheel is rotating. So I will do a depth lesson about a wheels in wheels. Those wheels keep on rotating. You know. So you got a mothership and a small ship called the Seraphim. You know. Those Seraphim, they just attach to the mothership. That's a wheels in wheel. And the wheels in wheel is rotating. So the mothership is rotating like a whirlwind, and the wheel within wheel, which are the Seraphim, are rotating like a whirlwind. Apostle Tara did a video about the Seraphim, a red ship and a small ships called the Seraphim. You can look at the Apostle Tara recent video. I am not making some stuff here. So I listened to the elder, and I knew he was going on somewhere in Mexico, some Latina countries there, a chariot split into seven ships, and he was going and talking about the Seraphim, man. Wheels in wheels, man. So today me, I'm going to talk about whirlwind, and the chariot move like a whirlwind, man. So let's go to this video and see a tornado.
Tornadoes usually rotate counterclockwise, but what happens when one is spotted turning the opposite direction?
Inside science.
A tornado is a violently rotating column of air that extends from a...
So, this idiomat is just going on to define what is a tornado. It's a violent rotating column of air that extends from the thunderstorm. So the Lord will come with a thunderstorm, a tempest, like a whirlwind, man. Those are, he's talking about the chariot, man. They will be rotating at the same time. First, they will be moving in a military formation, you see, doing some maneuvers while they are in their rank, man. They don't break rank, man. You know? Rotating like a whirlwind, man. Covering the whole sky, it will be a good sight to see, man. Esau don't even have a glimpse of Yahweh Bashem, our shy knowledge, man. Wisdom and understanding. Man. Because the scripture tells you, so the wisdom of this world are foolish. In the front of Yahweh Bashem, our shy, man. So you need to know. Let's go to this tornado. I'm just showing how a tornado moves.
Thunderstorm. And that's the general definition of it.
A tornado in the northern hemisphere usually spins counterclockwise, but on rare occasions it can twist clockwise and is called an anticyclonic tornado. Well, it all started.
The chariot, take that picture, man. The chariot will be moving like that, man. In between the wheels. In between the wheels. But let's see. Let's see the script. This is Ezekiel 10:6, and it came to pass that when he had commanded the man clothed with linen, saying, take fire from between the wheels, from between the cherubim, that went in and stood beside the wheels. So between the wheels, it comes that high concentrated energy, man, the fire, man, the tempest, sulfur. Have you seen the component of volcano, man? Sulfur, it contains sulfur. Sulfur burn your ass up, man. So there is sulfur there. And between the wheels, where that high concentrated fire comes, there is pressure there. So that pressure can cause a thunderstorm. Like how the tornado is moving. The chariot will be meter high in the sky, and that pressure will come directly from within the from between the wheels. That's where the fire comes. That pressure will be against the ground, and it will create a whirlwind or a storm, a tempest, like a tornado, man, moving in a counterclockwise or clockwise motion, like how the chariot is moving. So that's the whirlwind that's there.
With actually video, we got a video on our TV station from a lady that lives in the neighborhood where it went through it. And I'm saying, that thing looks like it's going clockwise. And I kept looking at it, you know. And so then finally, when we had a chance to really sit down and look at it, you know, when we're not on the air, you could see it was going clockwise.
You can also see the anticyclone here on the radar. Red indicates winds moving away from the radar, and green shows winds moving towards the radar, creating a circle.
That's how you find a tornado, the red next to the green. Well, you look to the red next to the green, it was flipped opposite to a clockwise, sure enough. The very next day, the National Weather Service went down and surveyed the damage and said it was a rare anticyclonic or clockwise.
So this is 2 Kings 2:1, and it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind. The chariot came, that pressure came, and it created a whirlwind, man, a storm. You see, a whirlwind is there, man. That pressure will either beam you up or destroy you. What do you see? The chariot beam somebody up. That's physics, man. You have Hashem, Hashem is a master of physics, man. Application of different pressure angles, forces, then you will be beamed up, man. That's the same pressure can cause a whirlwind, man, a storm, a tempest. At the same area, it can come high concentrated energy. Where does high concentrated energy be produced? When there is an application of high pressure. So where there is fire or high concentrated energy, there is high pressure. So that's why the chariot is called a whirlwind, man. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tell here, I praise thee, for the Lord has sent me to bless thee. Elisha said unto him, as the Lord lives, and as thy soul lives, I will not leave thee. So they went down together. Verse 9, and it came to pass when they were going over, the Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what shall I do thee when I am taken away from thee. And Elisha said, pray. That's another verse. And it came to pass as they still went on and talked that, behold, there appeared a chariot of fire. That's the fire enfolding itself. That is a pressure, like a whirlwind, counterclockwise and clockwise. They are called anticyclone. The horses of fire parted them both asunder, and Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. So I told you the whirlwind is a big application of pressure, different forces, centripetal force and the centrifugal force. Centripetal force is a force that it makes something go in a cycle without breaking its rank, man. Centrifugal force is an opposite force, man. So there will be centripetal, centrifugal, man. This is different force in which is out outers, man. At the end of the day, you will be beamed up, man. I can't comprehend the majesty of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. So I will leave it like that, man. So I hope you get the glimpse of how the chariot is calling a whirlwind, man. Let's continue. Let's go to Job. Let's go to Job there, man. Yahweh Hashem Yahushai answered Job in his style, man. He told him, "Gird up your loins like a man and answer my questions," man. And the Job was trembling like that's the Abba Shemia. He's a dreadful power, man. He comes in a whirlwind. Don't think that he just created a whirlwind out of nowhere. This is a chariot, man. Remember, the chariot can be invisible. Those are the one which creating this natural disasters, man. These tornadoes, man. Those are chariots, man. To tell you, if you don't believe, then fuck off. They are creating this earthquake, man. Because a chariot can defy gravity. It can change different forces, man. Remember, this universe was created by different forces, man, and elements, man. The chariot are able to manipulate those forces. They don't only manipulate elements, they manipulate those forces, man, to create something, man. If you disrupt the channel flow of energy inside the earth, an earthquake can happen. In the sea, a hurricane can happen. In the air, a tornado can happen. So those are chariot, man. The chariot is the one which parted the Red Sea. Come on, man. The chariot is the one which parted the Red Sea. The chariot part of the Red Sea, the chariot is the one who created this. Yes, the chariot is the one who created this tornadoes, man. Let's go to Job 37 and 9. Out of the south came a whirlwind and a cold out of the north. See, a whirlwind, a chariot, man. You can't see the chariot, but you can see a tornado. So Yahweh Hashem Yahushai is praying with these different forces, man. Centrifugal force, centripetal forces, reactive force, and anti-reaction forces. This gravitational pulls, you see, and the different innermost part of the earth, force and the pressures, you know. There is different mechanism which holds the universe together. So Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, since he can defy those forces, he can create a tornado, man. So what the hell are you talking about? So that's it, man.
In our hemisphere, tornado that touched down just southeast of Shelbyville, Tennessee. And the way they described it was a rare and unique EF1 anticyclonic.
This is Inside Science. Inside Science. If you enjoyed this edition, follow us on the web and social media. Powered by the American Institute of Physics and a coalition of underwriters.
The very next day, the National Weather Service went down and surveyed the damage.
So, this is another video
It's the video that's making even skeptics do adopt take.
See?
It's the video that's
video.
Making even skeptics do a double take.
This is another video that will show you how the chariot rotates. Even the pilot is so. So the chariot, I am sure they move in a rotational motion, counter, clockwise, and clockwise. Eh? Look at that scene.
It's the video was shot by U.S. fighter pilots on...
It
it's
done,
the video
yeah.
that's making even skeptics do a double take.
Listen carefully,
the video.
Look at this thing.
The video was shot by U.S. fighter pilots on a training mission off the coast of...
The chariot creates these different tornadoes, man. What are you talking, man? This is Isaiah 66 and verse 15. Man. I know this verse. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariot like a whirlwind, man. Counter rotation, counter clockwise and clockwise rotational movement. Those are maneuvers, man. Not only the large chariot for you who don't believe, the large chariot who move in military formation, they maneuver. Not only do they maneuver, this different maneuver, they can levitate, they can disappear, they can create a tornado, they can create a squeaky, they can burst up your eyes, they can cause an accident. To render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire, man. A chariot. Let's envision this. A chariot coming like big balls of fire rotating, man. And at the same time, it's creating a huge tornado, man. Hey, man, the destruction by the chariot is a beautiful sight to see.
Jacksonville, Florida. Pilots reported seeing mysterious objects that could reach hypersonic speeds, 5 times the speed of sound, and still turn.
The chariot only moved at Mach 5. When we say Mach 5 is the speed of sound times 5. So the pilot can see. A chariot can move like a thunder. Not a thunder, like a lightning. A thunder, you can hear a thunder. Like a lightning. Can you see a lightning? A lightning, you can see a lightning when it is turning. That's it, man. That's a chariot there, man. So... What are you talking about, Esau? What are you talking about? Mr. Esau, what are you talking about? Jeremiah 1 to 4, man. My man, Jeremiah. Yeah. Jeremiah 1, you know. Jeremiah 4, yes. Verse 4. And 13. Behold, he shall come up as cloud and his chariot. Remember, the chariot represents cloud and his chariot shall be as a whirlwind. So, what are you talking about? His horses are swifter than an eagle. Woe unto us, for we are spoiled. Woe unto you, two said. I hope I'm not among the two said. You will be seeing a tornado coming and a chariot in the top. A huge pressure, man, at the bottom. Everything will be moving in a counterclockwise motion, in the clockwise motion, counterclockwise motion. You get your ass get busted up. Since remember that pressure can take things. When the tornado is moving, have you seen a tornado? Different logs and the trees will be taken up because of that pressure and the forces, man, created by centrifugal and centripetal force, man. Those trees will be moving up to the tornado, up, and that. Hey, man, do I need to explain further? Do I need to explain further? Yeah. So the Lord can manipulate those forces, and a person can be taken up to the chariot in a swifter way, or you can be destroyed by that force. Praise be to Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shai, by Hashem, Lakakadash. Let's finish with the Kalah. Then I will leave with that. I think you have understood what I want to talk about. Let's go to This is Zechariah 9, the 14. And the Lord shall be seen over them, and his arrow shall go forth as a lightning, man. The chariot move like a lightning. Esau is saying, they move at Mach 5. Even this fighter yet move at supersonic speed, man. The chariot only moved at that speed so that Esau can see and come to report. That's it. Chariot can move like a lightning. If you don't know even what the lightning is, then you don't have nothing, don't have anything to say. It is the Lord God shall blow the trumpet and shall go with whirlwind of the south, man. Praise be to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahshai, Bashem, Lakakadash. So, note that the chariot are dangerous things to meet. Them angels, man. The Bible, or the scripture, or one angel can destroy the whole world. How does you think that happen? He can mess up with the force. This universe is operated by special forces, man. He can go there and mess up with the force, and then everything. You will see tornadoes everywhere, man. You will see earthquake tornadoes everywhere here, man. Do you think an angel can come and strike here in Tanzania, strike in West Africa, strike in America, strike? No! They can mess up with the elements, they can mess up with the different forces, man. Yeah. So you should know, man. That was it, man. I hope the lesson was a divine. Until next time, Shalom, brothers.